Hello, beautiful people. The Canadian National Exhibition returned to Toronto in late summer 2024 with thrilling rides, carnival games, live shows, unique food, and shopping. I'm super excited to share the best moments I had at the CNE this year. We'll check out the opening day ceremonies, enjoy live entertainment, and watch the sky come to life at the 75th Canadian International Air Show. Toronto's largest annual fair kicked off with opening ceremonies hosted by Gurdip Ahluwalia, Toronto radio personality and former CP24 breakfast anchor. The opening parade was led by the Toronto Police Mounted Unit, followed by the band of the Royal Regiment of Canada. Toronto Deputy Mayor Ozma Malik and other community leaders joined the parade as well.
I do officially declare the CNE open!
Look at all that confetti! An extreme sports show with skateboarding and biking stunts was new to the CNE this year. Some new food worth mentioning include the ube sesame street corn, Taylor Swift themed deep fried cheese curds, and dragon's breath, which is a frozen dessert made from colorful cereal dipped in liquid nitrogen. Inside the Enercare Center, there were beautiful flower themed displays where you can take Instagrammable pictures. There is also a carnival exhibit with artifacts from old carnival rides and arcade games. This is an unifon, a 1920s musical instrument that produces music using electromagnets. Do you like cats? I had a chance to meet a few at the CNE. Here are some cool things I saw at the gaming garage. Like last year, there were claw machines and lots of prizes to win. You can also buy Star Wars movie posters. One of the best live shows at the CNE every year is the ice skating and acrobatic show. They always make it better than the previous years. This year, the show's theme is centered on Hollywood movies. It once again features Elvis Stojko, a 3-time world champion, 2-time Olympic silver medalist, and 7-time Canadian champion in figure skating. The International Pavilion is where you can shop products from around the world. You can even get free newspapers from various countries. Aside from shopping, you can catch cultural performances at the international stage. The first one I saw was by an Indigenous group known as Odawa, Wiingushk. They consist of three dancers from three different Indigenous nations of Turtle Island. The next performance showcased traditional and modern Māori music and dances by two Māia, a Māori performing group from New Zealand. Hawaiian Pacific Magic brought Hawaiian music and more traditional Polynesian dances to the stage. I went back to the CNE during its closing weekend to see the 75th Canadian International Air Show. The air show was a spectacular display of precision flying and dazzling aerobatic maneuvers that left everyone amazed. Thank you for watching my video. And don't forget to like and share. If you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe and turn on your notifications for more videos like this. Bye for now, and I'll see you on the next video.